I don't remember much about my old house, except the smell. It always smelled of roast vegetables. The flat we live in now reeks of gin and dope and my mother's perfume. I sometimes choke on it. I float. I soar high over the rooftops of London. I swoop down to give Big Ben a high five, flap my arms frantically so that I just about dodge a head-on collision with a tower block. The soft, cool wind gushes past my ears, and I'm a mighty Concorde heading towards the ocean at 1,000 miles an hour. The water greets me with a cold smack and folds itself around me as I sink deeper and deeper, faster and faster, and bang! I land on the ocean bed. I lie there for hours in the cool sand with fish and other slimy sea creatures. I wiggle my feet and wave my hands and drool like a newborn baby. I can breathe underwater and I sparkle like a drop of liquid sunlight. I wake up. I wake up. I always wake up.
Me sleep at night. She's a bit of a nutter, that one. Honestly, Jenny, I think she's still a virgin at 50 and she's always looking down her fucking nose at me just because I have a bit of fun. She'd begrudge a child a biscuit. I'm telling you she would. She'd begrudge a child a biscuit. She says she thinks it's a sign of depression. She's the one without a life. And her husband, apparently, they go to bed at 8 o'clock every night. They never even speak to each other. She doesn't know anything about depression. She doesn't know a thing about it. She's had a bed made for her, that one. Have you seen the house she lives in? Oh my God, you should see it. It's got 5 bedrooms, 3 separate toilets. And they tell me she keeps her room just for the sunbed. I mean, what's the point in that?
She never goes abroad.
Mum!
What?
I don't feel well.
Well, you can just nip down to the shops for us. I've run out of Malibu again.
Does this mean I can stay off school today?
Well, all right, but don't go making a habit out of it.
You all right there, sweetheart?
That was a nasty fall.
Did you know we're all asleep?
You get dressed, missus.
What's the point? I've nowhere to go.
Told you yesterday I'm expecting company. I can't do with you under my feet all day.
Right, then fine, I'll go outside in the cold on my own. My own mum wants me to catch pneumonia.
What was that?
What, I didn't say anything.
I heard that.
Never said anything.
Well, you can go to the shops for me. I need some light bulbs for the bathroom. Oh, and while you're there, you can get me some more Malibu and lemonade.
Anything else?
Just get to it, will you? Oh, and don't go through that park.
I had a friend once. She looked just like you. That same sad look on her face, as though all the troubles of the world were just heaped on her shoulder. Of course, I never saw her quite as sad as you look now. Why didn't you come and join me on that bench? You'll catch you off in this cold.
Okay. Charlie, I'm so fed up.
What's the matter?
I just can't. But where have you been, Charlie?
I think you already know the answer to that question.
Why?
Well, I'm what they call a nomad. Always have been.
I've never really had any friends. There were a few people I got up to no good with years ago. But I've never actually had any proper friends. What's a nomad, Charlie?
It's like a gypsy. Always moving on. Never outstaying my welcome. Staying as long as I'm needed. Always happy and moving on. Anyway, this friend I once had, the one that looked just like you, she was always like a fish out of water, always unsure of herself, always uncomfortable around people her own age.
I think that's what it might be with me. I'm not frightened though. People just don't like me.
That's because they don't understand you. At your age, cruelty from your other schoolmates can be its worst. I can promise you that. So you're not like them, but who cares? Aren't they all asleep? You said so yourself.
But I didn't mean that they're really asleep. It's just, they want to settle for trying to outdo each other, and they miss the point. Oh, there's more to life than smoking and being captain of the netball. Oh, it's not that, Charlie, it's something. Can't put my finger on. It's how people don't seem to feel.
I know exactly what you mean. It's like on days like this when it's been raining and it's cold and there's all the gutters are just flooded with water and there's all these multicolored leaves just floating past. And there's people just rushing straight ahead, never looking down.
Or too important to look up. Too busy spying on other people. This rushing around makes me dizzy, Charlie. You know, I feel like you've always been with me.
I think it's wonderful. I think it's the cold that's making you remember.
Well,
it's like on a day like this after a week of rain and the sun comes out and the single scent emitting from a blossom can trigger off little flickers of memory that you just can't quite seem to place.
Where have you been?
A
few minutes, what are you talking about? It's nearly dark. You've been gone for hours.
Mom, don't embarrass me for a Charlie.
What are you talking about? Oh, my Christ, you're burning up. Oh, dear. Oh.
Don't worry. I'm still here.
Yourself. Your health should be the most important thing for you at your age.
Oh, it's only a cold, Charlie. I'm gonna die.
Shush.
What are you doing? Well, if you got a spare pen, I've lost mine. You said you were always gonna pay attention.
No.
Well, can I have yours then? It never bothers you. You give us back after? Of course. Cheers. That was a bit rude. She never even said hello to you.
Oh, I think she's not quite.
Yeah?
I used Jenny there, we're working together.
Oh, right, okay. With Jennifer?
Yeah.
Oh.
Jen? Jennifer! Are you ready for school yet? It's getting late.
I don't know if she's even going today, you know. She's had a really bad cold lately.
Don't wake up the old bloody street with a mouth like that.
Don't be so bloody cheeky.
Come on, let's go.
And I want you straight back here after school, young lady.
Jennifer, you shouldn't speak to your mother like that. It's disrespectful.
Well, she's a bitch. Like your mum. She's
slapped her. Are you going to let her get away with that?
She just brings men home all the time.
What's the matter with you?
Anyway, sod it, you can tell.
What? Today? You can't, it's a school day.
Come on, we'll miss the bus, hurry up.
We haven't even got any money for fags or anything.
Well, can't we just ask someone?
Well, all you have to do is ask someone for some money for the phone. When they get the purse out, the clocker must have got in the purse and then snatch it and run. If you're scared, then ask someone looks like a mug.
No.
Come
I don't
on.
Know.
Don't be so boring.
Will you promise you won't leave me?
Excellent. Come on.
I was so embarrassed picking you up from a fucking police station of all places. How could you do that? I haven't brought you up to go mugging people. And two bleeding 10-year-olds, no less.
Mum, I've got to go out. I've got to see how Charlie is.
If you think I'm going to let you see one of your mates now, you are staying in.
Please, Mum, he's not well.
Well, his mum can look after him.
No!
Don't bloody argue with me! You don't deserve friends. You have completely blown it, Jenny.
I'm going.
No. No.
Get off us.
Not.
Help.
Oh, Jenny, I didn't mean it. Come back.
Charlie! What's the matter? Are you in pain?
You feel.
I love you, Charlie.
It's coming. Can you feel it?
Feel what?
Trees. Sky. Something's coming. Something wonderful.